Wait for some people to join in. Paisley 5 and Dime going live tonight, and we're just going to see if we can get a few people in here on a Saturday night and just see what happens. Let's see who joins in. It's going to be kicking around for a little bit. Right now, we've got a little bit of the MPG rolling, the Good Life 12-inch, and just hanging out. Miss Lulu is out of town at the moment. She is out in New Mexico, so she's not with us at the moment, but she'll be back a couple days. So while she's away, we're gonna go a little live inside the Paisley 5 and Dime. And who we got with us tonight? Who's in there? Say something, give me a shout out, whoever we got with us. So we got two eyeballs, but I don't see any people, so let's see if I can fix this here. Seven people. Let's give a shout out. I don't see the comments. Anybody see? Anybody know how to turn on the comments on this thing? Ah, there we go. Linda Rios. Hi, Linda. Amy is in. How you doing, Amy? Amy is my little buddy out in Vegas, little sis. Donna Hare, how y'all doing tonight? We, it's good, Rodney. Big Rod, Prince 365. Go check out the page if you need all the up-to-date, all the news that is news going on in the purple world. Prince 365 is the page to go to. Amy, my sis out in Vegas. And Salvador, oh, we got our brothers and sisters across the pond. Missy White, Missy's my, she's my sister from another mister. Let's see, had a great day. Glad you had a good day, Amy. So right now, this is not quite the Five and Dime. This is a part of our house we call the media room. And the media room is kind of where we hang out and listen to music. And as you can see, we got some Steve Park prints. Those are the Christopher Tracy prints that he did. I see this is the one with the lyrics, and this is the one that was plain that didn't have any lyrics on it. There are only five of this one made. And the one with the lyrics, there's some of Santa Fe, Miss Lulu's personal collection, the little lollipop at the top. She got that because Brown Mark gave it to her. So, Travis Thurman, what's good, brother? Glad you could join us. Who else we got in here? Paul Anthony. All right, the book collection, of course. She got her bus. She liked to read and stuff like that. Some of the little princely items she's got going on. This is a print Steve Park did. I put the photo it came from down at the bottom. I got this a few years ago. It wasn't part of the Paisley 5 and Dime collection that we've done together. And if y'all haven't got it, y'all need to get this. Gone Daddy Gone. It's a poster that Steve did. He was gracious enough to sign for me. It's this was done a couple years ago, and it was all the icons that had already passed away. So it's called Gone Daddy Gone. And man, it's a good thing it wasn't done here recently, because our boy would be on there. So as you can tell, we got a lot of Steve's work in here. We love Steve. He's a good friend. Steve's been here. We got the art prints from the newspaper, and this is one of the gifts my baby got me. So if you can see the lyrics, song titles in the artwork. So this is how we get down. Come over to the house. You got to use the coasters, right? But we have other coasters. You know, if you're gonna get down in this house, P is the order of the day. You got to have some prints in your life. So right now we're listening to a little bit of the MPG. I'm a little down. a loop don't matter if the sample don't fit. So I can't do one thing at a time. I mean, you all are on the Paisley Five and Dime. You're also on P-Bay. And so anybody that's been around me, see me work online, you know I don't do one thing at a time. So I'm sitting here jamming to some MPG 12-inch, and we also got a little bit of... got some Love Sexy Live going on the TV. So let's see what else we got going on here. We got some old-school record player. Old-school. Got some of the picture discs representing. There's a few of them. And then some more of my Steve Park prints framed all nicely. This was the first one that Steve did with the Paisley Five and Dime. It was a controversy 35th anniversary. And, man, what an amazing piece. Really loved it. So from there, we ended up doing a few more. The Christopher Tracy print that you see there, that was the second one, and there's two versions, so there's an alternate on that if you're lucky enough to find them. This was the third one. This is the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, While My Guitar Gently Weeps. This one was a private commission that he had from someone else. This was not part of the Paisley Five and Dime collection. And, you know, we... Prince is everywhere in here. Everywhere. So, got our Electric Fetus bag with the 12-inch singles that were reissued. And got the lithograph, Steve Park lithograph for Graffiti Bridge. And when Steve was here, he was gracious enough to sign it for us. He came over, had dinner, you know, just like that. So anyway, what do y'all want to see? Hi, Shauna. Good to see you. Max Mercedes. Yeah, I saw you, Max, doing the splits on there. Anytime prints and posters gets mentioned together. And my brother, Rick Barros. What's going on, Rick? Yeah. It's good to see you all. Man, got a lot of you tuned in. We got 30 going on right now. That's beautiful. Hey, listen, here in Lexington, in the big, you know, whopping metropolis that is Kentucky, we've hosted some pretty amazing events here. We've had Maite, we've had Des Dickerson, we've hosted Steve Park, we've hosted Susan Rogers. We've done some pretty amazing things here in the big city or big state of Kentucky. So Lexington had a tribute for the last 2 years, and we were at this last tribute, and there was a live band playing, but there was an artist there too that did a one-of-a-kind right there on the spot and was looking to sell it. So of course Miss Lulu, being the art fan that she is, she had to snag it. So that's a one-of-a-kind from an artist here in Lexington. He was doing it right there on the spot. Oh, hey E, what's going on? My girl Angel, baby, you know I love you. Let's see, Chris Costanza, jewelry, got Get Wild perfume, old ticket stubs. Yeah, I do. I've got both. I've got a bunch of old concert ticket stubs, and also got some Get Wild. And so you like the media room, everybody? See all the stuff going around. This is just a little quaint chill room that we have with some really cool little furniture. We got some of the Prince books, and of course we got our LPP Volume 2, LPP Volume 1. If y'all don't have those, what are you waiting for? LPP is amazing. Let's see, the room is awesome. Thank you, Jeannie. We've also got Offsheen's book. Gotta get. It's a must have. Picturing Prince by my brother Steve Park, and he was Eric and Amber, thanks for everything. Really cool that he signed that one for us. All right, so anyway, this is the media room. Not a whole lot going on here. It was cool meeting Troy and his wife last night. Oh, so Daphne, you were at the event. That's right, you picked me up a little brochure. I appreciate that. Hey, Eric, you really like my shirts, I can see. Marco, yes, I love your shirts. I've got several more in the drawers, but we ain't going through my drawers, you feel me?
No, it ain't happening. So, if y'all like the shirt, the guy that just commented in the post there, Marco. Marco is the one who designs these and sells them. They're amazing. They're good quality shirts. Shauna says, I'm broke. That's why I don't have them. Shauna, I know you broke because every time I see you was at another event. You went and saw Janet with me. Got to hang out with my girl, Shauna. Here's just a couple of the other things we listen to music-wise. So a little Rufus and Chaka Khan picture disc action going on. Little tassels that Maite gave me. So, Sharon MPG girl McAllister, gonna see her here soon. She is working on a little project for the Paisley 5 and Dime. So, y'all wanna see the house? We're not going through everything, but give you a little idea of how Prince really does permeate every bit of our great little existence here. That's the foyer, but when you come in, this was a news article that was done about the Paisley 5 and Dime after Prince passed away. The local media sources here reached out to me to do an interview, and they came and saw everything, asked a bunch of questions. So anyway, moving on in, we're heading towards the Paisley 5 and Dime, so don't give up just yet. We're going to get there. Here is our Merry Princemas tree. Merry Princemas to all of you. Got little buttons all over. Little symbol globes. And of course, the Paisley 5 and Dime. Because that's how we get down. Who love Prince? Everybody love Prince. So yeah, he's everywhere. Well, in this house. And what I've also found, a lot of people, much like myself, people that love Prince as much as I love Prince, also had another thing for genius when they see it, and they had a thing for Robin Williams. Hey, Charlotte. Hey, Chris. I see Chris Costanza. What was your first piece, and when did you start your collection? I've actually started my collection twice, Chris, but I'm going to get to that in just a second. Robin Williams is another icon of mine, and I followed Robin and I followed Prince closely my entire life. And my lovely Miss Lulu got me this. It's just like, it's the same artist that did the one of Prince in the other room. She commissioned this and had it done for me, and I mean, it's huge. There's personal messages hidden in there too, so it's for me. Hey, Debbie D'Angelo, how you doing? Heather, it's good to see you. Carla Taylor, Maggie, man, loving all y'all guys tuning in. This is wonderful. We're getting ready to go downstairs. I'm gonna flip the camera around so that I can see what you all see as well, if I can figure out how the hell to flip it. And there we go. So, this is going into the basement. There's the news article that was done about the Paisley 5 and Dime. That's the little metal thing that they make the papers out of. Let's see. Third Eye Girl. Forever. Here's some posters that I just don't have enough room to hang up yet. Take you through. Here is the Paisley 5 and Dime Prince Collector's Haven. A few things. Some art. We love art. Everything art is awesome. So, let's see. Electric Fetus and the Paisley 5 and Dime stickers on the CD cabinet. Here are some of my Prince CDs or Prince related items, random grabs here. Anything y'all want to see in here? Let's see. Peter Gaynor, oh my. See, Merry Princemas, Diane, Kimmy, very cool. Nice to see you guys. Stacy, good to see you. Who else we got in here? Man, there's a lot of y'all. Well, great article. Saw the clip on YouTube before I met you. Wow, thanks, Angel. Let's see. Boom, love the Prince Forever poster.
So you like that one, Shauna? That's the one.
Let's see. Anybody got any questions about any CDs? The Black Album. Oh, yeah, we definitely got some Black Album. It should be right down here. Black Album, still got the sticker in there. Of course, I got the Black Album import, Black Album promo. And yeah, somebody said they saw a 4U 8-track. There's 4U on 8-track. Can I come live in that room? Betsy, a lot of people have that. Let's see, Rainbow Children, I see Crystal Ball, Hockey Puck. I've got several of the Hockey Pucks. Let's see, Diamonds and Pearls poster is sick. Yeah, check this out for those of you who have never seen the huge holographic. Let me see if I can move over here. Is it moving for you? It's kind of hard to see. Kind of hard to see it through. Oh, yeah, he's opening his eyes on us. It's pretty large poster, and it's got the huge hologram on it. It was done for promotional use only. Let's see, Dirty Mind Cool. Can't wait to get my art. Oh, man, the new Steve Park print that we just did with the Paisley 5 and Dime is absolutely amazing. They're being shipped out right now. There was a small incident. There was an automobile problem. So they were supposed to go out Friday, but there was a small delay, but all fixed. So they're going out this week. So see, yes, he's moving. Just bought the DMP at thrift store for 99 cents yesterday. Good deal. Good snag. Diamonds and Pearls. Love Diamonds and Pearls. Looks like you can touch and pull him back. Oh, Genie. That was my boy. I loved him dearly. And if I could pull him back, I would. Yeah, I really can't even talk about it. Let's see. There's a little poster that I picked up at Hi-Fi in Minneapolis. It's a little Recostol down by Loring Park. If you haven't had a chance to go in there, please do. They are very respectful of prints. And Shauna says, you've done a lot since I came to visit. Yes. Robin, where's your gold, Eric? Which gold? I've got a lot of gold. So, you gotta be a little more specific, darling. Let's see. Anybody recognize this? This is the Proofs for Raven to the Joy Fantastic LP. This is the proofs that they made to get the album covers printed up on. And for the cloth banner. There's some of the proofs with the little writings and stuff on it. We ain't going in on that. But, yeah, Dirty Mind, Around the World in a Day, For You, and Purple Rain Still Sealed. Robin says, the poster you were telling me about, the gold poster. I have to refresh my memory. Now, when you come into the Five and Dime, we have Purple Candy. I know that shocked some of you. Like, really, why would somebody have purple candy in a print store, right? It makes no sense. So, any questions? Anybody got any questions about Five and Dime operations? So, you're really wanting to see the absolutely recognize. Yeah, there's some great stuff in here. Peter, I've been collecting and been following prints for about... I first started listening in... I guess 1980, I caught the end of the video for Uptown. And when I saw the end of the video, I didn't know what I was looking at. But about a year later, I saw the video for Sexuality. And that really kicked me into gear and made me want to collect. So I did. We got Leslie. Leslie coming in from Tennessee. Big Laverne. So, about 96... I wasn't doing anything with Paisley Park anymore, and I sold my collection off, started having kids, raised a family, and now, I guess a few years ago, kind of got back into it, and I'm so glad I did. So actually, everything you see, I've acquired just within a few years, because I sold
the biggest bulk of my collection off back then. And see, Kim Blanchett, thanks so much for showing something. Yeah, I'm getting old, so I gotta adjust the glasses from time to time. Let's see, is this a real store that you can go into anytime? Well, I mean, you can come, but you need to like call me because it's also my house. Need some original promo picks for the For You Through Dirty Mind era. For You promo picks, okay. How about this? Does this work? Let me get it turned around here so you can see it. How's that? That is some print work that was done, some advertisement back in 1978. And love it, love it, love it. Yeah, Chris, I've been very busy. Here's some other poster shit. Let me turn this around so y'all can see. There's just so much going on down here. I got the For You With Love, There Is No Death from Parade. There is a promotional card, big piece of cardboard, When Doves Cry. This is really an amazing piece also. It's a promotional item for the Symbol album. Debbie D'Angelo wants to set up an appointment to come visit. Let's see. I got a Love Sexy poster, and then I'm going to go back through some more comments. Yeah, we got New Power Soul hats, Lexus Fetus, all that stuff. All right, so nice, nice, nice. He was 20 and 78, yes, that's true. Was there one piece that you didn't part with from your original collection? No, not that I can think of right offhand. I sold almost all. I kept a copy of all the albums on CD, and that was about it. Everything else I sold because I had so many rare collectible pieces. This is an art piece that a local artist friend of mine did and gave it to me. Are there things that you sold that you regret selling? JD Washington. JD, you know, the biggest thing I regret selling, there was a Love Sexy Mobile, and I've not been able to find it again. It was a blue arrow and a white arrow that were juxtaposed, pointing in different directions, and you hang it from the ceiling, much like this, you know. So I got the Emancipation Mobile hanging in the middle of the room. But I missed the mobile. I wish I could get that back. Let's see. Peter Gaynor, loved to see anyone related to MPG when I first saw them. Favorite period. Monica, I'm in the big state of Kentucky. And yeah, most people don't think that stuff like this comes out of Kentucky. But hey, we bleed purple here too. There's a promo shot from the mid-90s, Prince and the MPG. Anybody recognize this? Know what this is? Carla Taylor says, do you have the second ending to Under the Cherry Moon with outtakes? I've got some Under the Cherry Moon outtakes, and I have the alternate beginning, but I do not have the alternate end. So the answer to that would be no. And so, anyway, who out there knows what this is? We got 50 viewers. Wow. That's pretty awesome, guys. And I love seeing that Prince still gets this much love. Yes, Chris, it is a picture disc. Debbie D'Angelo, Kentucky proud? Hell yeah, we are. Do you have the 3 James of Gold comic book collection? Yes, I will get to those in just a minute, Sharon. See, where do you find all your goodies? All over the world. I'm in East Tennessee, pretty close. Yeah, you are. And you should come visit. You need to get with Miss Ballard, who was just on here, get with her, get with Missy. They live down there close to you. Have I ever met Prince? Kimberly Short, have I ever met Prince? Yeah, I met Prince a few times. I did some work for him back in the early 90s, but I didn't get to meet him back then. I didn't end up getting to meet him until like 2001. And it was a really neat encounter. I'm not going to waste everybody's time with all that because it's just a, you know, it's a meeting story. Flip through some vinyl here. There's Minneapolis Genius with the hype sticker. Emiko, yes, you finally got it. The Girls and Boys Shaped Picture Desk. Just got one. Let's see. 12 inch for Just Another Sucker promo. Got a For You with an autograph. Let's see. What kind of work did I do for Prince? I did anti-piracy. I was the one that nobody liked because helped them bust bootleggers. Let's see. I lived in Vine Grove, Kentucky. It's a great state. Let's see. We got a Greece import of the Prince album, U.S. Why You Wanna Treat Me So Bad promo. Promo for Dirty Mind. Oh, man. It just goes on and on and on. There's so much stuff in here. Here's some of the latest things, the later years. Artificial Age, the Black Album.
For those of you that don't know, the Black Album was just issued here not too long ago on clear vinyl and looks really good, sounds pretty good, but as always with the Paisley 5 and Dime, we are here to educate. And the new Black Album issue that came out is a bootleg. It is not official. So don't be fooled on eBay with all these, you know, clear vinyl, super limited edition. Nope, it's a bootleg. So this is a great little piece here too. His name was Prince. It's a double vinyl set. And as cool as it is also a bootleg. So don't get fooled. Prince, Hit and Run, Volume 1 on vinyl. Once again, bootleg, don't be fooled. Hit and Run Part 2, once again, bootleg. Forever, this one is legit, that's the real box set. See, The Purple Era, that was an unofficial release. The reissue of I Would Die For You with the large center picture. Let's see, some picture discs. If I Was Your Girlfriend, Sexy MF. If I Was Your Girlfriend Again. Oh, looks like we might have one of these on the 5 and Dime soon. I didn't realize I had two of them. Let's see. Kiss with the plinth still in it. Yeah, that's tough to find with the plinth still in it. And another one with the plinth. All right, so now it's education time. So the Paisley 5 and Dime is all about people knowing what they're doing collecting, because collecting is such a hard task because there's so many variables that could happen. I'm going to show you a good example of that with these KISS picture discs. There are two KISS shaped picture discs. We'll save that one for a second. And I hope this one is open. Hang on just a second. Nope. There it is. Bear with me just a second while I get this open. Alright. So, anybody notice anything different between these two KISS-shaped picture discs? JD, what is a plinth? A plinth is a little piece of cardboard that if you take it out and fold it up, it will make a stand for the record to stand up in. Unfortunately, when these were released, they were limited edition, and most people that, oh, the free plinth, they took it out and they formed it up and stuck the record in it. So the people that didn't now have a plinth, and those, if you have the plinth, that makes this even more valuable. Let's see, oh, I need that kiss, and if I was your girlfriend. All right, so education time. Does anybody see any difference between these two? Anybody know the difference? One difference right off the top that you'll notice is this one has a large hype sticker. This one has a small hype sticker. If you go back to the original with the large hype sticker, you'll notice the catalog number, and if you look right here, it just says KISS Prince, and this one just says Love or Money on this side.
Yeah, Max Mercedes. The barcode, his barcode is different. This is W8751P. Now, what we're going to do is slip over here. That one was Kiss. This one is Kiss Extended Version. And it's a totally different UPC with catalog number. So they are completely different. This one has the extended version on it. It was a reissue. This is the original with the large hype sticker and the regular version of Kiss. It does not say extended. If it says extended, it is the reissue. So now just a little bit of education from the Five and Dime. That's what we here for. So any other questions before we move on? I know I'm missing a whole lot of comments and I'm trying to get to everybody. It's just hard to show some of the stuff and field questions at the same time. So there's the Thunder picture disc, Arms of Orion, Party Man, Black Sweat. Here is the Bat Dance picture disc. This is the Batman soundtrack picture disc. They look the same, but one is different. I Can Never Take the Place of Your Man, Thieves in the Temple. There's New Power Generation. So a lot of picture discs. There's more that's not even there. Like the original Little Red Corvette 1999. I turned it into a clock. Rhonda wants to know what's the most valuable piece in my collection. There's several, but I really can't say one is any more, because that's kind of subjective. Here's some tour books. Got that recently. It's not a tour book, but it was really cool. I went ahead and picked it up. It's an old Cashbox magazine from 86 with Morris Day on the cover. Jeffrey Ballet, Fox Theater. Here is a book from the Soul Train Music Awards with Prince and Janet on the cover. One of our fellow collectors, Joe Orozco, secured that for me. Let's see. Here is the Parade, Purple Rain. Let's see what else we got. Piano and a Microphone, some flats, some promo flats. The Purple Rain movie book, not the tour book, the movie book. The Truth, Sign of the Times. All right. Education time again. Y'all ready, boys and girls? All right. Who all has seen the Love Sexy Tour Book? There's a billion of these floating around. And if you look down here in the corner, they say Love Sexy 88. These were part of the U.S. tour, the English tour over in Europe. Let's see. Oh, it's cool. Soul Train. Yes, it is. But anyway, on to the tour books and education time. This is the Love Sexy 88. There's, like I said, there's a million of these out there floating around. It's not too difficult to come by. This one is the exact same book, except all the dates have changed to 89. This is the Japanese leg of the tour. Yeah, the different Love Sexy books. So yeah, Emmy's hip. I don't have it open, but there is a info sheet in there. Yeah, Bob, there's two different Parade tour books also. I don't have the other one. I'm sure Mr. Bob does. Bob Popo is another one of the bigger collectors in the world. Around the World in a Day, MPG Dance. Let's see. Nude Tour, Diamonds and Pearls, Act 1, Act 2, Gold Experience. There are two different Gold Experience books too, except one is the Gold Experience and one is the Ultimate Live Experience book. So there's a couple pages that are different. You got to be real careful as to which one you get. Jam of the Year tour book, Morris Day tour book. Oh, autographed Morris Day tour book. Yeah, I didn't buy it autographed.
I've actually known Morris for about 20 years, and he signed it for me. Let's see. For those that haven't seen this, this is Hit and Run Part 2, Third Eye Girl. Autographed by, let's see, there's Josh, Ida, Josh again, let's see. Or no, there's, that's Ida, so this would be Donna. That's Donna Granis. Ida Nielsen, and there's Miss Hannah. So Josh, Donna, Ida, and Hannah, they all signed this for me at Paisley Park when I was up there seeing them at the Plectrum Electrum listening party that turned into a concert. Let's see, it's really one of the coloring books, in my opinion, most sexy with the stories. Yeah, and the makeup that he's got on. A little crystal ball book. This is a really neat item. Musicology tour book. Welcome to Australia. I actually got this from Mr. Bob Popo. One Night Alone and the 2003 tour book. And then, of course, the Paisley Park tour book in the back. We're not going to go through all this stuff. Just pointing out some of the like neater little things. This is a 3121 window cling. Another tour book. Anybody know who these girls are? They showed up on my doorstep one day. Act One tour book and the newspaper. Do you have, or can you talk about Emiko? If you're talking about the newspaper, you're talking about from the Act One tour, would be called the Morning Papers. There was a small newspaper that came out, and they were little promotional items. I don't know if I've still got my morning papers. I used to. Bob Popo, the European Parade Tour book has printed in England on the last page, that's all. The Japan version doesn't, and the Japan version comes with a huge fold-out Sheila E. poster. That's what I'm talking about, because the poster of Sheila in the other one was really great. Some of the associated stuff, the time, what is this? George Clinton... double colored vinyl. One is green, one is red for Martial Law. Who knows about this? Both of them, actually. There's the promo. There's the release. Aretha Franklin and James Brown. And y'all hip to this? Do you have the Crystal Ball CD set in the round plastic holder? Yes, I've got a few of those, Sharon. Hey, Mei Ling, she just joined in. So, who knows about this? The Aretha Franklin, James Brown, Gimme Your Love 12-inch. It contains a single edit and extended remix by Paisley Park. Yeah, this is very tough to get. There's a couple of them floating around on eBay. They're not really expensive. They're not too bad, but they're not easy to get either. So you got to do a little homework to get it. But they are fantastic, great pieces. Let's see, St. Paul, green vinyl, the original Time album with the original hype sticker. What Time Is It? Ice Cream Castles. Pandemonium on vinyl with a card from the show that they did in Vegas at the Flamingo. Attack of the Killer Bees. It's really neat because if you really like the Time and you're going to be a serious collector, you're going to need this track. Grace, the B-side of 777-9311. You're going to need that. If you're going to have a serious collection, that's part of it. Nadeem Masood, yes, sold the CD recently. Aretha and James. Yep, I actually just got that not too long ago. Not from you, different one. The Time, Get It Up, promo 12. Cool 12-inch signed by Morris. Morris is very cool. He has signed a lot of stuff for me. As you can tell, there he is again. Jungle Love. So, anyway, moseying on through. There's some of the vinyl, some more of the vinyl, and a few of the magazines. Let's see. Max, do you have a pair of his shoes? People don't realize how small they were in person. I don't have a pair here, but I've had a pair here not too long ago and sold them. Here's some of my other CDs. I listen to everything, so it's not at all uncommon. Oh, y'all seen this yet? This is great. If you haven't got one of these yet, you need to get one. Chris, wow, do you have insurance for this? Hell yes, I got insurance for this. I ain't that stupid. Yeah, it's all insured. When you have a collection like that, you have to. So anyway, gonna play a little something, boys and girls, fans of all ages. I'll let you all take a look at it here. Probably help if I turn on the volume. Tell me if it's too loud when it starts up. Hot with you. Hi, Shari. Here for a second. A lot of people don't realize that there was a 12 inch of Hot With You and had a couple different mixes on it. Yeah, Chris Costanza, Hot With You 12 inch. So, has anybody heard this version before? It's different lyrics. Too much of it. It's about a 6 minute version, so. Yeah, it's enough, because, people will be stealing that shit just off the little clip that I played right there. Don't think that they won't. We'll skip forward a little bit here. All right, so. Yeah, it's, Underneath the Cream on vinyl, it was on the Hot With You
hot experience. Hi, Jason from Wisconsin. Nice to have you here. We're going to turn that down for just a little bit and go back to this art. This is what the stage setup was for the Get Off video. So if anybody remembers the Get Off video. Hey bro, do you happen to have a recording of the Vegas Studio 54 MGM after show 99-2000? Yes, but we're not going into that. Let's see, Chris Costanza flips out of Super Cute too, right? Yes, Underneath the Cream was the flips out of Super Cute. If you got one of the very limited edition CD singles that were at the concerts or through Prince himself. So, Paul Anthony Cortana, yeah. That's the stage setup for the Get Off video. And I'm about to back up to get this thing in here. Some of you watched the last video may have seen this. This is the U.S. promo of the Love Sexy poster. And I had some people ask me about it last time when I showed it. They said, oh, that was just something somebody made. So if you get down in here, 1988 Paisley Park Records, made in the USA, for promotional use only, not for sale, Paisley Park. So, the scandal behind the Love Sexy album, as you know, was many of the stores wouldn't display it. They wouldn't display the promotional pieces because of their own little hang-ups about a little bit of skin. Prince is showing a lot of skin. Let's see. Whoa, how can we talk? I was on stage on that show, and he put me on a mic. I started a funky chant. I must acquire big love. Yeah, I don't sell bootlegs, Jeffro, so that may be a little difficult. Can't get into that. So anyway, that's for a different page. Can't do that in the five and dime. So anyway, okay. Wanna see my girl up here? Got her hanging up. And 1999, the new remaster with lyrics. This table has a lot of really cool stuff in it. Let's see. You might recognize that. The glare is on it, too bad. Whoops. Don't drop it. Anyway, you get the idea. There's God, there's stuff everywhere. Let's see. That was my birthday present. From Steve Park, he gave that to me for my birthday last year. I thought it was very nice. I was pretty excited about it. And this was a gift. What I'm about to show you, you can't see any other place because there's only two of these in existence. And here's one. So, anyway, it's four images from the Hit and Run 2000. On one big print. Light's kind of messing it up. Anyway, another framed piece. So anyway, we need to get back to some questions. Who's got some questions? We've got more stuff going on around here. I'll flip it around. Let's see. Here's some of the stuff you'll be seeing coming up on Five and Dime here soon. There's a lot of stuff. So,
Anybody hip to this? Jill Jones, bald. Anybody hip to this? It's her vocals. I wasn't hip to it, but I listened to it just a little while ago. It wasn't horrible. That's all I'll say. It just wasn't horrible. Let's see.
There's some art pieces I made. Those are the actual albums for Madhouse and Vanity 6.
And I'm sure all the collectors have this. You got to have the Sign of the Times poly bag. Here are a bunch of books, Prince books. Everything. A little bit of everything in there. I keep in these drawers down here is where I keep all the periodicals, magazines, stuff like that. And this little cool piece right here. Okay. 1999 banner. Love Sexy banner. 88-89. And before you ask, yes, that is his shirt. Let's see. I'm trying to read some of the comments here. Fake, that was the jam. Oh, you talking about this. All right, Fake was the jam. And there were two versions of the 12-inch. So, anyway, Angel was making a comment about it being a jam. Yes, it was. Let's see, love the Paisley Park glass. So much amazing stuff. You're so blessed. I've spent a lot of time on this. Let's see, magazines, yeah, tons of magazines. Rick James and Prince together on tour, just bootlegs. Rodney Fitzgerald, the 3 o'clock. I do have the 3 o'clock. I'm trying to remember where that was. Got a whole stack of Sheila stuff getting ready to hit. Anybody recognize this? How long did it take you to rebuild your collection after you sold it? I don't know. I'm still building. Let's see. Have you read all the books and magazines? No. No, I have not read the books or magazines. This is a art piece that another friend of mine gave me back in 92. And I loved it. It's a great piece. Does anybody know how to turn off this damn flash? That'd be super. Because now I'm stuck with a flash on here. Shari, is your collection bigger now than the first time? Yes, it's a lot bigger now than the first time. Tony Mon's album is amazing. Is there anything he recorded that wasn't released? Unfortunately, Tony Mon's passed away. And so any unreleased stuff, I don't know about. Here's some photos from First Avenue. Sign of the Times promo watch. All right, Jeannie wants to know, what's the story with Rave Into and Rave Unto? Okay, you know what? It's a good question. And I've answered it several times. Several of the big collectors have answered it a bunch of times. So while we've got you here, we're going to go ahead and take care of this right now. All right, Rave Unto comes in the white digipack. It has the little poster thing in it. The CD looks like this. There's the Rave Unto the Joy Fantastic. Here are the tracks. All right. Now, Rave Into the Joy Fantastic. A couple things to look for. Rave Unto, Rave Into. On Unto, his eyes are looking back. He's giving someone the side eye, right? So Unto,
He's doing the side eye. Into, he's looking at you, kid. Into, he's looking directly at you. Unto, he's looking away. Rave into also has a mispress. Because on the side it says rave unto the Joy Fantastic. On the front it says into. The CD, whoops, I can't show you because it's sealed. Whoops. Anyway, here's the track list on Into. Rave Unto the Joy Fantastic, Rave Into the Joy Fantastic, and this is a remix. Everything on here is a remix of the version that's on here. There may have been one. I think The Sun, the Moon, and the Stars wasn't any different. Tangerine was slightly extended, if I remember correctly. Bob's on here probably still, so he can correct any of those little things. But yeah, Rave Unto the Joy Fantastic and Rave Into the Joy Fantastic are two totally different albums. If you have one, that does not mean you have the second one. And if your Rave Into does not look like this, if your Rave Into comes in the little slip case, you got ripped off. That is a bootleg. This is original. This is original in a jewel case with the correct artwork. The little thin ones that you see on eBay all the time for whatever hell price they can get out of them. Sometimes they be ripping people off pretty bad. They are bootlegs. They are not legit. So don't be fooled. Don't spend your money on bootlegs. Some bootlegs are fun to have. If you can't get it any other way, that might be a way to go if you just want to hear it. But if you just want to hear it, there's a ton of fans out there that will hook you up and take care of you and let you at least hear the stuff without charging an arm and a leg. As a matter of fact, if it's a bootleg, they should be giving it to you. See, Pretty Man Isn't Listed, is it? No, Pretty Man Isn't Listed on either one. It was a hidden track. Didn't hide from many Prince fans. They mostly found it out pretty quick. So Rave Unto, two totally different CDs. You do need to get them. If you have bought C-Note on CD, you got ripped off. It's a bootleg. If you bought Chocolate Invasion on CD, you got ripped off. If you bought Expectation on CD, you got ripped off. All of those were internet-only downloads. They are not official releases. So they are only worth about the cost of whatever it costs to produce them. And trust me, the cost of producing a CD is next to nothing. So there's a lot of people getting ripped off out there. Do not buy Chocolate Invasion. Do not buy C-Note. Do not buy Expectation. Do not buy Rave Into the Joy Fantastic unless you know for sure that it is a legit copy. If you need to know if it's a legit copy, ask me. Send me a picture of what they're selling, and I will tell you if it's real. Was Crystal Ball ever on vinyl? Chris, no. Never even heard of a such thing. I wish it was. That'd be very nice. Crystal Ball would be a nice set. Unfortunately, it'd probably be a 5 or 6 LP set. Not that that's a bad thing, but it would be very expensive. Sharon says, I need Rave Into. Yes, you and a bunch of others, because it was a very short-lived CD. See, y'all want to say hi to my little buddy? He sits over here in the corner and watches me all the time. You want to say hi to him? So what's up, P? He sits here and keeps me company. Oh, yeah, Brad Brissett. Yeah, Slaughterhouse is also a bootleg. Sorry about that. Forgot that one. There's a better shot of me. Anyway, there's P. So some other misconceptions. So we got Slaughterhouse, Expectation, C-Note, all bootlegs. Slaughterhouse, yeah, you said that. I'm trying to keep my thoughts straight here. I just realized I got a little ahead of myself on this. This is Tommy Barbarella's Tunic from the Dolphin video. Or no, the Gold video. So if you saw the video for Gold, this is what Tommy was wearing. I had someone ask me recently if it was gold or silver. It is gold, and it is a foil
adhesive that's on there. Shari said that's going to be mine someday. No, it ain't.
Oh, she's probably talking about the standy. A few things. Let's see. Purple raincoats. Yeah. Prince did condoms. That's funny. Some newspaper articles. There's the cologne. Several of those. Let's see this. MPG Records. It's a little CD booklet. So, anybody got questions, anything like that? I'm going to turn on a few tunes. We got 62 people still with us. Let's see what kind of tunes we got. Hot What You Remix.
Another Hot What You Remix.
So, questions, anybody? Do you have the perfume 3120? Yes, I do have. I have the Get Wild perfume, and I also have the Micah Simpson is news on vinyl a bootleg. If you've got news on vinyl, you've got a bootleg, Micah. It sure is. Hi, Lenny. Lenny Beeson in the house. Here's another remix for you. Rodney Fitzgerald just asked me if I had the Rainbow Children lyric book. Rainbow Children lyric book. You got to give me a moment to dig for it here. I do. It's in my paper goods over here. All right, Rodney. Ask and ye shall receive. Here is Rainbow Children lyric book. So, who else has this? All right, so anyway, I'm gonna go. Allison Ryan, such a beautiful man. I hope you're talking about Prince. Let's see, Hot Remix, Brad. I'm going to try to go through some of the comments here and answer some questions. Let's see. What's your rarest and most valuable collector's item? I've got several. And since I've got some personal effects, I'd say some of the personal effects I got from him would be most valuable. But they're mine. They're not really, they're not for sale. They're personal pieces. Let's see. What's the, that's the joint, baby. I love your Hot With White promo. Yeah, it's the one we were just listening to. It's great. There's six tracks on it. Micah says, I don't have it. LOL. Just seen it online a few times. Yeah. Crystal Ball on vinyl. Total ripoff. Do you have the Pink Cashmere Pope promo 12-inch? Not many copies out there. I have one of them. Yeah. The Pink Cashmere Pope 12-inches, they're very nice to get. Promos. Let's see. Shauna says, your boo is out of town. You lonely. Amy also asked, where's Amber? I started the video, and Amber is out west right now. She is handling some business with her company, and she will be back here soon to
spend some time with you guys online also, and we got some more things to do for the big party. Who all out there is coming to the celebration kickoff party? It's going to be huge, huge, huge. We have some more secrets getting ready to drop. I still can't tell anybody who it is. We've got several people still lined up that we're going to be bringing in. There's only like 30 tickets left. 30 tickets left to the celebration kickoff party on April 18th. And man, if you got friends that haven't got their tickets yet, you need to tell them to get on that, because I don't think you all are ready for what's getting ready to drop on you with this party. Some of the people I can go ahead and tell you, we got Troy Gua coming in. He is the LPP artist. He's going to be there. He's going to meet everyone. We have got Alfonso Star and Purple Funk SF is coming in to DJ the event, and they are going to absolutely turn this joint out. You feel me? They're going to teach everybody the funk and roll dance. We are going to get the whole place jumping off. It is going to come unglued. See, who else we got? The mayor of Chanhassen is coming. He's coming to speak to everyone. He was very happy whenever we first started talking and said he couldn't wait and was very excited that I extended the offer. Is Sheila E. going? Allison asked if Sheila E. is going. I don't know. I haven't spoke to Sheila, and don't know about Sheila. So anyway, we also have Michael Dean from the Prince podcast. He will be coming and joining us. I'm going to drop something on you right now. There will be a live performance. I'll just leave it right there. There is going to be a live performance, so you're going to want to be there. And if you watch the Prince 1985 interviews, don't you like surprises? So, is MPG there? I will tell you that the MPG is not going to be playing at the event, but they will be represented. So I'll let you figure that one out. So who else we got? DJ High Top in the house. Chris, yes, Purple Funk SF. DJ High Top, a.k.a. Alfonso Star, is going to turn it up. That with Miss Gigi and DJ Spooky. Man, I'm excited. I haven't been able to go to one of their events, and I'm really excited about this because I'm going to get out there and cut loose. So, yeah, we're going to have... Jesse Johnson would be awesome. Jesse Johnson live would be awesome, Jimmy. And speaking of which, Jimmy Reardon just joined us. Jimmy, we need some more of your dance videos. Love your dance videos, bro. If y'all haven't saw Jimmy Reardon, look him up. He's just commented. Go check him out. He does some videos where he dances around lip syncing to the songs, and they are so much fun. So, date again. Jeffro asked for dating. Jeffro, we never dated the first time. Norvis wants to be in the video. Jeffro, that was funny. The date again is April 18th. April 18th at Glicks. It's not Glooks. It's Glicks. Glicks in downtown Minneapolis is one block away from First Avenue. So, if you're going to be in downtown Minneapolis anyway, you're going to be in town for the celebration, then you need to come on out and you need to get down, get your ass down there. But if you haven't got your ticket yet, you need to go to Eventbrite, the Paisley Five and Dime kickoff party at Glicks. That's G-L-E-U-K apostrophe S. Maite just scheduled a class. She's going to be doing a belly dancing class on April 18th as well. And she's going to be done in time that I'm going to stop by. So if you're going to her belly dancing class, you will get to see me. I'm going to come by and say hi to everybody. And
So the biggest thing is, if you haven't got your tickets yet, you need to do that. Like, trust me, go get the damn ticket, because it is going to sell out. Brad Brissett says, need your shirt. Brad, if you need this shirt, you need to go see Marco. Marco Diart, I think that's how you say his last name. But he's the one that does the design on these, and they're fantastic. Jimmy Reardon, everybody's saying hi to Jimmy. Man, go watch his videos. So what else we got? Questions about legit releases. I know a lot of people asking me about the CD singles that came out around 2000. Super Cute and or some of the other ones. Daisy Chain. There were Peace. Peace is a CD single that came out, and well, if you can get your hands on that, it is super, super, super rare. Let's see, I probably got one here. Show you what to look for at least, because you don't want to get ripped off. Oh, we're just talking about that with Nadeem Masood. There's the one that has the Paisley Park remix with Aretha and James Brown. Let's see. Peace CD single. This one, You Make My Sunshine. It's not easy to get, but it's not as rare as Super Cute. Super Cute and the ones like that are extremely rare. Okay. I'm trying to dig here. Bear with me. This one, Daisy Chain, that CD single is really, really, really rare. So, Micah, wasn't Underneath the Cream one of the singles from the 2000s? No, Underneath the Cream was a B-side, I think, of Super Cute, the Super Cute CD single, which I do not have, but that's where Super, that's where the Underneath the Cream came from. Let's go through a few things here. Somebody asked me if I had the hockey puck. There's the 5-disc version of the hockey puck and the 4-disc version of the hockey puck. So yeah, there's two versions of the hockey puck. Let's see. I'm trying to find my Peace CD single that I've got here somewhere. So anyway, in the meantime, anybody got any more questions that we could handle? Any questions about collectibles, promos, stuff like that? Somebody just said, I didn't know that Aretha single was on CD. It is, and it is a promo. Well, it's not going to focus in. Anyway, promotional item, not for sale, so that's the way to get it. It's probably going to get bootlegged soon too, so we'll help you out. There's what the CD looks like. Don't get taken. It also has some interviews. Those are very sought after by the completest collectors that go get everything. They're gonna go after that one. Anybody hip to this? Eric leads now and again. Anybody hip to that? Let's see. Shauna, I have the hockey puck. Do you have the Brian G, Most Beautiful Girl in the World? Well, sweet, you trying me now. Look at you trying to pull out like rare shit. Let me find it here.
beautiful experience, Canadian. Yeah, you got me curious now. Where did it go?
I do have the Brian G. It's Brian Gallagher, right? And it's a yellow CD with the symbol in the middle of it. I do have it. Unfortunately, I can't get my hands on it right this second. But I do have it here somewhere. I got to go through and organize my stuff. Got way too much. Let's see. So you're still here. Live PD is on. What's Live PD? I don't know what Live PD is, Bob. Are you going to be offering any swag at the kickoff party? T-shirts? No. We've got some pins that we're doing. They're going to be giveaways. We're not charging for the pins. I'm having a bunch of pins made that I'm going to give to the people that come to the event. That's just a little gift from me. The War was always one of my favorite singles. Rhonda, good one. Rhonda, thank you for calling that out. The War is a very, very cool thing to get. The cassette single is pretty common. You can get it. You don't really have to go into you don't have to go into your pockets too deep to get that. But if you want to get The War on CD, you're going to pay. The War on CD is incredibly, incredibly expensive. Let's see. The one that I just pull out here. So, yeah, The War on CD is very expensive and very sought after. Bob said, I thought everyone watched Live PD. Sorry. Buddy, I would if it was any good. I just don't know what it is. You got to tell me what it is so I can. And maybe I get up on that. Audrey Johnson is watching. Hi, Audrey. Damon Dixon. Damon's in the building. Where you at, Damon? Make some noise. Damon D. Where you at, boy? We need to get you and Kirk and Tony. Lots of bootleg War CDs out there. Don't buy. You know, Bob just makes a great, great point. He says, don't buy the War CD. It's a bootleg. If you're not paying a few hundred bucks, it's a bootleg. So, yeah, be careful when you buy the War on CD. Ask myself, ask Bob. You know, somebody that's not going to steer you wrong. You need to find some of the high-end collectors that you trust that are not going to steer you wrong. Do you have the version of Get Off that Prince put out on vinyl for his birthday? Yes, I do. That version was not released on anything else. And the version of Get Off that was done for the birthday release was on a white vinyl, a single-sided, and I think there's different stories about how many copies. Some people will say 500, some people say 1,000. Hey, Damon, what's going on, buddy? Great to have you here. We're just going over some of the more rare Prince collectibles, and we were just covering the Get Off birthday 12-inch that has now become one of the more highly collected 12-inches. Damon was in the MPG at that time. It was released on his birthday. The cover art was done by him. It was done by P. And it was called the Damn Near 10-Minute Mix. That's what it was called. That one is a really nice 12-inch if you can find it. I think there were some people selling it on the Paisley 5 and Dime on this page. There was somebody that had some for like 180. And that's not really a bad price. I think that's pretty reasonable. Hey, Damon, are you there? Can you still with us? Damon, you recognize this shirt hanging up back here? That's your boy Tommy. Tommy Barbarella's shirt from the gold video. So, anyway, let's see. Damon D from TDK is in the house. So, there's your boy Kirk's other project. If y'all don't know about that, it's KAJ. TKO was a little side project that Kirk did. It's really good. Yeah, you definitely got to pick that up. If you haven't got it, it's really good. I was super impressed to get that. And Damon, what was your favorite song? I like watching Damon on stage on the Act One tour for Damon doing what? Rock to the FLOW, the flow. Man, Damon was straight ignant out there on that stage. Boy, he was moving and grooving all over the place. And doing that little hop skip with Tony where he hops over him and they go back and forth with the hands. They did it on Arsenio, too. Man, those are some cold moves y'all came up with. It was quite impressive. You all on Arsenio both times was fantastic. You all really held it down. So I appreciate you being on here tonight, Damon. That means a lot. We're trying to save some of these collectors from getting ripped off by bootleggers and selling pieces that they're trying to pass off as rare when they're actually just bootlegs. So, did anybody see the Act One tour? There was only 12 U.S. cities on the Act One tour. I was lucky enough to catch Chicago up there in Bob Popo's house. Hey, Damon. Damon, you recognize these girls? You seen them around? Chris Costanza says, I have that Get Off 12-inch. What is it worth? Chris, there's people selling it right now on the 5 and dime for $180 for the 12-inch. So they had a few of them at $180. So, once again, anytime you flood the market like that, it drops the value. So, I'd say right now, a good sell on that would be about $175 to $170. You could sell it pretty quick. Let's see. Who else we got in here? Lenny Beeson said he saw the Act One show in Atlanta. Anybody see this piece before? I've showed it a few times. Steve Farnioli. Purple Rain, gold record. A little something from the stash. So, what other questions? Bob, if you're still on here, can you help me think of some of the more commonly bootleg things that we can save these people from buying? Sunrise Florida Act One. Now, Sunrise Florida, I know he did Sunrise on the Musicology tour. I didn't know he did that. Let's see. Bob says he was at Act One Chicago all three nights. Bob, I got to go to the first night and the second night. I didn't get to go to the third night because I had to drive back to Kentucky. But I went to the first night, April 4th, 1993. And I went to the April 5th, 1993 show at the Chicago Theater. And then Damon wants to know, where you located, brother? Damon, I'm in Kentucky. I know it shocks a bunch of people, but yes, I'm in Kentucky. And if you look around here, it looked like Paisley Park done exploded up in this joint. So, Damon, if you're still with us, me and Bob were just discussing the Act One shows from Chicago. And I was at the first and second show, but I didn't get to go to the third show. Mavis Staples showed up at the third show. And I had some people tell me about it, and I got to actually hear a bootleg of that show. So I got to hear it. But yeah, Mavis was at the Act One April 6th show. And I also got to go to the Cabaret Metro
after the second night and watch the after part or the after show down there that he did. Hey, Damon, do you remember the after show from Chicago 93? Probably not, but I'll refresh your memory. That's the one that Buddy Miles. Yeah, Buddy Miles came up and played drums on a couple of songs, and Malcolm Jamal Warner was in the house too. So Malcolm got up and did a rap with Prince that night. So anyway, don't know if you remember that night, Damon. I was talking to Sonny here not too long ago about it. Sonny was recalling it, and he was having some memories. That was probably about an hour before I ended up having to give Sonny a ride home. Sonny's good people. So P open to Sunrise, Florida Fract 1. Okay, very good. Damon, his collection is epic. Yep, I do. You remember that, Damon? I bet you remember the part of Malcolm getting up there. Or, see, Buddy Miles. It was a fantastic show. You all really turned it out. Brad Brissett says, Auburn Hills, December 97. You were there too, right? Yes, Brad, I was at the Detroit 97 show. And if you give me a second, that was December 27th, 1997, at the Palace of Auburn Hills. I was at that show also. And Larry Graham, Graham Central Station, opened. Okay, my phone's getting ready to die, so I'm getting ready to lose y'all here in just a second. I'm going to go upstairs and plug in so maybe I can hang on to you just a little bit longer. But Larry Graham opened the show with Graham Central Station, and then Prince finished the Jam of the Year show in Detroit. He finished it up with a Motown medley that was off the hook. So if you got to see it, that's amazing. Hope you did. Damon, if you're still with us, before I lose you, here's some of the other stuff we got going on. Damon, hit me up. Send me a private message. I need to talk to you anyway. So send me a private message, Damon, and I'll get back with you. I'll give you a phone number. You can hit me up. So there's a couple other people I just talked to recently. But anyway, my phone's getting ready to die. Hope you all enjoyed the little tour around the Five and Dime. Damon, if you're not in the Paisley Five and Dime yet, we'd love for you to join us. We have a lot of fun. We look out for other collectors, trying to make sure nobody gets ripped off. So, from the Paisley Five and Dime here in the big city of Winchester, Kentucky, Damon, hit me up. To the rest of y'all, Merry Princemas. We out. Peace.